the list is unbelievable.
It is unbelievable. I can't disagree with a lot of it. Obviously, a lot of the players I've never seen play. I've never, some of them, well, I've heard of all of them. But it's really interesting. I think what I want to hear from these guys is the characters behind those players.
Yeah.
You know, we've seen them on YouTube, we can watch old games, but actually when it comes to playing in finals and winning finals, it's all about what's inside. And that's what I really want to hear from Scully and Big Roy there and Keith Senior, and as to why they've picked these people. And in particular with Gary Schofield, I'll ask you a question now. I've always been interested, half-back partnerships. We've got Alan Hardesty on later on, and whenever you mention him, Keith Epworth comes up in the same conversation, and it's almost like they're a dynamic duo. You know, how important was an half-back partnership back then as opposed to now? And who was the best player that you ever played with, international or at Leeds?
Well, the best player, well, quite simply, the half-backs are the machine and the creativity of what happens in the rugby league field. I know forwards at times may not agree with that, but at the end of the day, your half-backs are the most important players on that field. Your forwards do the donkey work, quite simply, that's what they do, that's what they're there for. And then your pretty boys and your centres and your wingers, you know, they finish the tries off by the creativity of your six and seven. Today's game, I know it's changed a little bit because you have to play in the channel six and seven, but at the end of the day, it's your six and seven who get you around the park, you know, and tell realistically everybody where defensively, you know, they're a little bit weak, and you get the big guys, as we say, look, the way that Keith was, the way he played, on the, get on the outside and score the tries. But the way I've based my team, and the best Leeds team that's ever been, has been quite simply four formulas: pace, creativity, toughness, and mobility. And when I do give you my team, you'll quite simply, you know, see the reasons why I pick these players.
I'm going to say, what category do you fall into then?
I would certainly come into pace and creativity. I would say toughness would be way out of it, I'm afraid.
Do you think the game's sanitised now? It is what it is now, obviously.
Yeah, it is, unfortunately. The way the game's gone, but that's the way it is. It's not just one team's doing it. Yeah. Everybody's doing it. So you've got to realistically, if you want to, you know, you buy into the modern game and the way that they play, you know, with the way the structures, yeah, the way it's left side, right side channels. That's the way the game is, and that's the way that it is. So you either buy into it or you don't. But I would still, me as a halfback, I would like to see a little bit more creativity. I like to see the ball moved around a little bit, certainly, you know, on 22. When you've got big guys like Keith Senior who wants the ball, you know, thinking, well, I've not done enough for 20, 30 minutes, let him have a go, you know, from the own 20, 22, 30 yards. Because what that will do then, they will go down the field 30, 40 yards, take the pressure off you forwards, and then you can start getting involved at the halfway line rather than getting battered in your own 22.
That's why I didn't do enough for 20, 30 minutes. I couldn't get the ball off people like you.
What I remember, Keith, is that you weren't interested until we got past halfway.
Correct, it's all about scoring the tries, or like I used to do, put the wingers in for the tries.
Do you mind doing the donkey work, Roy? Is that what a forward's for?
It doesn't matter. I didn't bother doing anything because we used to say, we'll do the hard work, you score the tries, get us the winning beer money. That was it.
That's it.
So it didn't matter who
scored. It was all about the money for you guys.
It was all about the beer. The money wasn't in it. There wasn't enough. No.
Let's look at some of the players the boys have picked.
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, Roy, your team, you want to talk us through some of the players in your team, mate?
Yeah, John Holmes, fullback, great stand-up as well. John Holmes, you can read a game from fullback, tell you where to go, come in, come out, you know, see the gap. Alan Smith, great tough winger, great tackler. Sid Hines, fantastic centre and captain, hard as nails. Les Dill, big strong centre. John Atkinson, a legend himself, John Atkinson. All scored a winning try in a big game, got it out. Gary, what can I say about Gary Schofield that Gary Schofield already said?
We've still got another hour to go on that from Gary.
Kevin Dick, young scrum half. Kevin could read a game, great goal kicker. In fact, he's big Kevin Dick now, I think he weighs more than me actually. But Mick Harrison, the best number eight open side prop forward I've ever seen, strong as an ox. David Ward, another captain, cut him in half, leads through and through. Great enthusiasm. Steve Pitchford, the bionic battle. Nobody could handle him. He got the man of the match at Wembley, the Lanstod Trophy, and then he got picked for the tour the week after, so that's how good Steve was. Big Bill Ramsey, who I watched as a kid, one of my heroes. He was the enforcer. Bob Haig, at the time, leading forward tie scorer. Great player, another international. And of course, Ray Batten at loose forward, one of the classiest loose forwards I've ever seen. Couple of subs, we've got Graham Eccles, who pound for pound, the toughest man I've ever met in my life. Never take a backward step. And then, of course, I've got to put Ellery Allen, who's a class player. of the modern era.
Because you've seen, obviously, Leeds. You signed for Leeds in 72, and you've seen players before that and since then, and you haven't included any modern-day players. Why is that?
The team I've picked is because I picked the guys that I watched as a kid and the guys that I played with. If I picked anybody else that I haven't played with, anything like that, it's somebody else's opinion, especially the guys before. And the guys that's playing now, it's a totally different game. Whether they'd fit into our game or whether we fit into their game, who knows? Totally different.
Do you think any players nowadays would fit into your game, would make your team?
No. I'm only kidding. It's a totally different game. Of course they would. You know, they may be all fitting, really. Just totally different era.
I want to ask you a really dumb question here, right? And it's probably a bit of wording that died out as I come through. You talked about open side and blind side prop.
Yeah.
You said that as if you're really specific about an open side prop, what his job is and what he has to do. Just tell us what the difference was, if there was one.
Well, every scrum, you had to literally fight for the ball. Right. And this guy, Mick Harrison, he was the enforcer. Right. And he would literally grab the other bloke like that and stick his head into his neck. Somebody else would be doing something else. And somebody else would be kicking somebody else, and that was every scrum. And Mick Harrison, you had to do that to get the ball. If you didn't get the ball, these guys couldn't score and get us the pay money. So that's what it was all about.
Sounds like fun, Mark, don't it?
Was it a tougher game then than it is now?
It was a much harder game,
yeah,
physically wise, but not as athletic.
But also as well, I guess we're asking that question here, but when you look at the way the forward packs are today and the way the forward packs were in my day, and certainly Roy's, you know, they were playing for the full 80 minutes. There was no 12 interchanges. There was no coming off after 12, 15-minute spells, coming off for 20 minutes, coming back on. They stayed on the field. The only way they came off was if they were playing rubbish or if they broke the legs or broke the shoulders. They had to stay on for the full 80 minutes. So that, again, is a huge difference in the modern game to what it was back in our day. You never wanted to come off the field. And as I say, the only reason why you came off was if you were playing rubbish or you were injured.
Right, Gary, let's have a look at your team, mate. You've got a few similar names to Roy.
Yeah, very much so. Certainly the back line, as is mentioned, you know, with John Holmes, you know, a great read of a game, coming to the back line and scoring tries. The two wingers, Smithy and Atkey, you know, their record will never, ever be broken. If you wanted to try scoring from any sort of distance, they would score it for you. Again, the creativity from the two centres in Lewis, where Lewis is the all-time legend of this club. And quite simply, if you ask any Leeds fans who the best player that's ever played for this club, it's Lewis Jones. And
not Gary Schofield?
That's debatable, but what else, you know, Les Dill again, sheer quality, creative-wise for his winger, but also two score tries. Creativity-wise, myself and Jeff Stevenson, and you've got to pick Jeff Stevenson in because the greatest player who's ever played the British game allegedly has made the statement, and it's come from Alex Murphy, that Jeff Stevenson was the best player he's ever played against, and he played for our great club. So Jeff Stevenson has got to be in at scrum half, partnering me at number six. It would have been quite interesting, wouldn't it? And then the front rowers, again, you look at toughness and you look at mobility. And when I look at my pack of forwards here, it's mentioned Mick Harrison, David Ward. You talk about going into scrums and also to getting the ball in the scrum against the head and whatever. There's no better than Wardy. Crooksy, where you talk about a bit of toughness but also to creativity, he could do it all. He could do it tough, he could create, and also too, he could score tries and kick goals if you require. Ray Batten, ball in hand, creativity. That's why he's in the second row with Graham Eccles, because Graham would have done the tough work there for Ray Batten. And then the Pearl himself, Elry, who quite simply will score your tries. He'll tackle all day for you, do the hard work for you, and also to score your tries. So quite simply for mine, I think that's a perfect 13. And then on the bench, Arthur Clues. Well, everybody knows Arthur Clues, don't they? You know, toughness personified, score your tries running wide. And then himself, Mr. Utility, Mr. Perpetual Motion, and Kevin Sinfield. Kevin can fill any field, any position on the field, and plus as well with his leadership and his goal kicking. There you go, there's your perfect 15. If that was playing in the Challenge Cup this weekend, it's bye-bye Castleford.
Keith, you've gone different, obviously. You played the game in a different era. You signed at 99, played to 2011. It's actually only between 72 and 2011. I think there's only 4 years between you guys at the club, so we couldn't add a better representation for the Leeds Lioners, Leeds Rhinos tonight.
Yeah, I've gone a little bit where as Roy's gone. Obviously, he chose people that he grew up with and who we played with. Well, I wasn't a massive rugby league fan when I was a kid, so I didn't really watch the game. So I've gone by who I played with at Leeds and what they did, you know, and helped me through the game and, you know, what inspired me and, you know, some of the brilliance that they did on the game day. You know, so obviously at fullback with Brent Webb, played against him international-wise, and I think I think he, you know, epitomised the full-back row and changed it a little bit in the fact that he turned it into a little bit of an half-back row, you know, like Sam Tompkins moved to full-back, you know, he started off as a half-back and it turned into more of a ball-playing position rather than just a fielding the kick-return defensive position. Marcus Bae, obviously, as a wing, you know, the great Papua New Guinea, you know, loved him on my wing, just solid. You know, never took a backward step, only ever saw him get smashed once, and that was by Sonny Bill in the World Cup Challenge. You know, so some happy memories from him, but he was just an awesome player. You know, he got the ball on the 10-metre line coming out of yardage, you know, he'd make some good 20, 30 metres. Kevin Iroh in the centre, it was in between him and Richie Blackmore, they're both very similar type of players, and probably, you know, the biggest thing that let them down was the fact that sometimes they couldn't be bothered, but on the day, they could do the damage, you know, and they were devastating. But I went for Iroh because I played against him a lot more and saw, you know, in the international and, you know, when he played at Hunter Mariners and, you know, in the Australian side. So I had to pick myself. I'm a bit like Gary. I knew that I wouldn't get in his team, so I had to make sure that I got my name in one team. Ryan Orr on the other wing, you know, he speaks for himself, what he's accomplished. And senior at six, you know, he speaks for himself, what he's achieved in the game. You know, he's the most successful captain to, you know, for silverware at Leeds, you know, in my era. Robbie Burr at halfback, you know, he created so much for me personally. And, you know, he's still doing it now. Obviously, he's in the nine role now, but, you know, he can revert to seven and he's just a devastating player. Big Adrian Morley at prop and Jamie Peacock, you know, they're the go-forwards guys. Danny Badiris, you know, in between him and Terry Newton for the starting, but I thought I'd go for Terry Newton if I needed a little bit of tough, stealing it up in the middle. Tez Newton, he could do that. But, you know, for Bedsey, for his skill and, you know, what he achieved in the Australia game and then came over here, was a great influence on a lot of our young kids in that era. I could have thought Matt Diskin because he was great and I knew that I could get the ball off him. The only thing that let Bedsey down was when Bedsey and Peacock played together, there were no chance of me ever getting the ball. So he could have got pushed out for that. Second row, Ellis and Ali. Ali, for me, was probably the best second row that I've played with for his, you know, his offloading ability. His service that he could give me and, you know, some of the magic that he brought out. Ellis, again, speaks for himself. And Anneli is the only one that I've never played with in the team, but, you know, I was very fortunate that I got the chance to play against him. And, you know, it speaks for itself. A few people will be surprised by the sub of Daz Fleury. It was in between him and Barry McDermott, but I think Daz, he did the little things. He did the hard work and he did a lot of things that people never saw in the stands, but us as players, if there were some mess to clean up and some hard work to be done, and he'd always do all that work behind the scenes.
Right, during this break, you're going to have to confer and you're going to have to decide between you who is the actual greatest Leeds team. Big thanks to Keith, Garrett and Roy for all your teams. And at the end of the show, you've got to confer now, because at the end of the show, Keith, you're going to be presenting your combined League's greatest team. Who have we got after the break, Jonesy?
We've got rugby league character Mick Morgan.
He's joined by cast legends Alan Hardister and Bob Maybar. Tune in after the break for more Rugby AM's League's Greatest.
League's Greatest, brought to you in association with State of Mind.